In front of me today, I have Motorola's latest flagship, the Moto Z2 Force. Keeping the same modular theme from last year, this self-proclaimed durable phone has solid specs, built into a surprisingly thin body. Motorola is pushing that shatterproof screen again, so let's see what this phone can really handle. My Mohs picks do a fantastic job of differentiating between different materials by their relative hardness. Plastic is soft, so it scratches at a 3. Glass is harder and scratches around a 6. And real sapphire, like the HTC U11 Sapphire Edition, is basically impervious to scratches, landing at an 8 or a 9 on Mohs scale of hardness. Shatterproof screens are normally made from plastic, like we've seen with previous Motorola phones and the Samsung Active series. This Z2 Force is no different. Plastic. This obviously has its benefits. Your screen will never break, and that's a huge plus. But the softness of the plastic leaves it more susceptible to superficial damage. As you can see, even my fingernails, which are a level 2.5 on Mohs scale, can leave a mark. So it scratches pretty easy. Motorola has replaced this outer plastic covering on previous phones for a reasonable fee, and hopefully they continue doing that with this model, so customers, like us, can replace them if necessary. The home button is not scratch resistant either. My razor blade does do some damage, but luckily it does remain 100% functional, even when it's excessively scratched beyond normal use. Thumbs up for that. My fingerprint still unlocks the phone every single time, without fail. The earpiece is recessed inside of the phone, and it's made out of that thin vinyl covering. While not as durable as a metal earpiece, at least it's not going to fall out on its own. Now, Motorola has paid special attention to the front camera of this phone, adding its own front-facing dual-toned LED flash for you selfie lovers out there. The only problem is that the camera is still covered by that same plastic as the screen. So one fingernail scratch in the wrong spot and your pictures are ruined, until you have Motorola swap out that top layer of your phone. Adding a simple screen protector over the plastic would solve this problem though. The dual 12-megapixel rear cameras are covered by glass, finally. So that is scratch resistant. These cameras aren't wide-angle like the LG G6, or telephoto like the iPhone. The dual combo is just for depth effect, which is slightly less useful in my opinion, but still has a nice bonus over the average phone. Motorola says the body is made out of 7000 series aluminum, the same high quality stuff that Apple started using with the iPhone 6S, and it definitely sounds like metal. One awesome thing that I want to point out, if, by chance, the screen on your Moto Z2 Force ever breaks, Motorola has a warranty for 4 whole years. That's longer than Donald Trump's gonna be president. Super cool of Motorola to stand behind their product with such a gigantic warranty. The gold pins at the bottom of the phone are for all the modular components that magnetically attach to the back, like a speaker or bigger camera. Personally, I'm most excited for that projector. The sides of the phone do have the same premium feel of metal that we expect on flagships. The top is metal as well, and even the buttons are made from metal. Down here at the bottom we have a USB-C port, and an unfortunate lack of headphone jack. Having no headphone jack rules this phone out for me as a daily driver. I treat my phone like a tool, and a phone without usable basic features is not worth my time to carry. Headphone jacks are a dime a dozen, and wireless headphones are not always accessible. Maybe someday in the future, but today is not that day. The screen of this phone is pretty darn awesome. 5.5-inch 1440p OLED, and most importantly, not ever having to worry about your screen breaking during a drop. That peace of mind is really truly amazing, even if you do have to compromise with the front plastic. The screen lasted 10 seconds before the plastic melted and the screen turned white, leaving a permanent bulge in the top layer and a permanent white spot on the display itself. If you ever do drop your phone, it will survive unless it's dropped in fire. So try to avoid that. To be modular ready, this phone is shockingly thin, and I fully expected it to flex more than it did. There was a little screen separation from the main body, but since this phone has no water resistance rating, nothing's being compromised. Bending from the back yields no destruction either. The phone is extremely solid in its construction. While this phone might not be the phone for me, it still gets my approval. I think it's awesome that Motorola is pushing the limits of design and functionality with their mods. Some of them are super appealing, like that projector. I think I'll have to take an inside look at that in a future video. What do you think? Would you prefer a plastic shatter-resistant screen or a glass screen? Let me know in the comments, and come hang out with me on Twitter and Instagram. I have a lot of big videos planned for the future, so hit that subscribe button, and thanks for watching. I'll see you around.